I can empathize with you. It certainly strikes a nerve to an old story of mine. And so what I would say is that you have a muse to your problem right in front of you that you've watched for 4 years in every kind of environment go through this. Would you say that I have changed in the last 4 years in regards to communication? Mm-hmm. Would you say that I changed in regards to communication to appease others?
Delivery style, maybe.
Do you think I changed it for them or for me? Let me rephrase it. Do you think that I changed it or that I changed?
You changed it.
Okay. Like I'm not in control of it. Oftentimes we've gone back and looked at certain situations and said, like, I don't even know who that person was that just got done speaking. So, 'cause I wasn't controlling it. My adventure, specifically in the last 2 years, has been self-awareness and the willingness to be versus being who I think I am. And what I hear you saying is that you're saying, this is who I am, and I want to just say, fuck everybody else. But really, that's like me 2 years ago. And I had to get into a place where I said, I must be willing to be something different. My message never changes, never has changed. My delivery's changed because it went from here to here. And for a while there, I probably didn't have a heart. Probably didn't even have a heartbeat for years. And so it would have been impossible to operate from there. But over the last 2 years, I've made this transition back. And it's not about the right or wrong. It's about, while the person's saying these things to you, you saying to yourself, what of this is real and what if it's not? And just being willing to do the dance and not trying to turn the page on it and be done with it. Because there is something like this when you get to know really truthfully who you are. Like, I mean, I was particular way for the large period of my recovered life. And then I became willing to not be that person anymore. And it's something that I'm doing the dance. It's like I'm willing to not respond. And then sometimes someone else shows up and just starts talking for me. Where we could have predicted the future based on the past, on how I would have responded. And this has taken a long time. It has been a very painful stretch of growth and change. And sometimes I still question it. Like I can hear Joe W. saying, like smacking me or something and saying, "What's wrong with you? Where's your salt?" or whatever, I don't know. But then I've seen too much. You know, I've seen too much growth from it personally, as well as I feel better. Like I'm not like this wound up heart attack waiting to happen. And that's really who I was before, controlling everything. And so, you know, are you asking yourself, are you limiting yourself by these thoughts that you're having? When I hear you say you're wanting to you know, be done with this and turn the page on it, that's limiting, because it's not something that you get to turn the page on. It just is something that is. And because you live in this life around these guys all the time, it's like living underneath the microscope, where the average person doesn't have authentic interaction and communication, but maybe like, you know, an hour tops a week. Like, tops, and that would be like probably not even close. My guess would be more like half an hour for the average adult, authentic communication within a week. That's including themselves. Probably half an hour. We're here, it's all the time. And so then that's the part of identifying where you are and seeing that for what it is and accepting that as part of your adventure. And you can be on the blessed side of it, like you get a lot of practice, or you can be on the cursed side of it, which is you get a lot of practice. But one thing that I know for sure is that it's not always going to be like this. So if you see things for what they are in the moment, then you're able to love it and maximize it now, because the one thing we know for sure in life is that change is coming. And it may not be tomorrow, it may not be when, how, or what we expect, but it's irrelevant to the now. And so, yeah, first, you know, it's kind of a shitty thing, dude. Our stories are a little bit different, because really when you came in, you didn't have a voice. You didn't use it. You had no clue how to use it. Then you finally learned how to use it, right? And you began to be who you are. But then people started saying they don't like the way you use it, which then pricks the old story of the codependency of really the core of where you came from. So then now you're in this position where you could just be like, fuck you, douchebag, pull your panties up and, you know, move on, and I'm not going to let this affect my old story. Or I'm going to say, well, okay, well, I'm not trying to hurt your feelings, pull your panties up, and maybe I can say it a little bit differently. So the story doesn't change, but the willingness to approach it differently does. And there's a lot of it that, you know, most of the time, I'd say probably 99% of the time, I would believe that people, as much as I've changed, you know, knowing where I came from, most people would think that I'm pretty hard and mean. But they don't know where I came from. And at the end of the day, it doesn't matter what they think. I don't care. It's not my purpose. My purpose is to be authentic. And my purpose is to be willing to be the best me that I can possibly be. And for the people that know me the best, they know that that's who I am. And so it doesn't matter if it's right or wrong or this or that. It just simply is for the people that it matters to. And for the others, who cares? We're not here for anyone else. And there are going to be people that don't like the way you talk to them. That's okay. And if someone said that to me, I'd say, you know, okay. That's okay. Sorry that you feel that way, you know, but no, actually, I'm not sorry that you feel that way. Pull your panties up and let's go. Because I'm in front of you and this is who I am and this is what we do. It's not always going to be rainbows and puppy dog tails. And that, in the relationship, the other person has to say, okay, well, I forgive you and I'm working with you because I know my position and who I am and where I am. I'm not just throwing my toys down and walking home. Because you know what? Walking home ain't a fucking option. And for some of you guys, it still is. Like, but I'm here to tell you it's not an option. So, you know, you got to remove that from your repertoire of reactions to people saying things to you. And you got to be willing to get into the conversation, man, knowing that you're going to get hit.